Okay, so Celine, good reaction in there?
Yeah, awesome. I mean, it's frustrating. We wish we could tell more about Toy Story 3, but, you know, we're still 10 months out, and we want to keep some surprises for people. So we're just having to tease a little bit here and there at this point.
That's good, you know. But you feel today Ken is in the movie.
Yeah, it was awesome. You know, we announced today that that Ken, Barbie's paramour, is part of Toy Story 3, and that he's voiced by Michael Keaton, who's an actor we love working with. He did a voice for us in Cars, and he was a blast to work with. So it was really exciting to that he agreed to play the part of Ken. We created a little fun piece for Comic-Con, which is kind of a retro 80s interview with Ken that went over really well with the crowd, and hopefully we'll be able to share it with the rest of the world at some point in the future.
Excellent. Will Ken be, I guess, rubbing Buzz and Woody up the wrong way? You know, another alpha male in the in the equation?
Well, you know, what's funny to us about Ken and why we wanted him to have him in the film is that we realized it's a very interesting character. He's a guy, he's a toy who is a guy who's a girl's toy, right? So you got to have some hang-ups surrounding that. And also, he's ostensibly an accessory for Barbie. He's not even his own toy. He's just like, he's as important as a pair of shoes or a purse to Barbie. How does that feel? Yeah. You know, I mean, this just seemed like comedy gold. And it's something we've explored quite a bit in the movie and been having a lot of fun with.
Cool. And this is the second Toy Story 3 character reveal. Am I right? There's a small hint in Up at one point.
You know, I've heard rumors out there, but they're just rumors as far as I know.
Okay, yeah. Okay. But this, obviously, you've been involved with the first two movies, co-director of the second one. Is this a natural progression for you?
I'm happy to be here. I'm happy to be working on a Toy Story film again. You know, I've been at Pixar for 15 years. I came to be part of the original team that made the first Toy Story. And it's been a long, crazy journey. I've worked on a lot of films. I co-directed Finding Nemo and Monsters, Inc. and Toy Story 2. And I've gotten to work on a lot of great stories. But the Woody and Buzz and the rest of the gang are characters that are very near and dear to us. And we're happy to be able to extend their story in this film.
Years have elapsed in the movie world.
Well, I think Andy is about 10 in Toy Story, and he's 17 going on 18 in Toy Story 3. So it's been about 7-8 years.
Absolutely. So, what has that meant for the relationships between the toys? Have they deepened? Have they richened in that time?
Yeah, certainly. I mean, you spend all your time with the same people day in and day out. We always. It's interesting that the show The Office is so popular now.
Yeah.
When we created the dynamic of the toys in the first Toy Story, we always likened their relationships to being like a bunch of people working in an office together. That was the dynamic we came up with. You know, what is it like? What are toys like when they're alive in a room? What's the dynamic between the toys? And it was very much an office kind of a thing. So it's kind of fun seeing that's become such a popular thing. All these years have gone by, and people get on each other's nerves, and relationships blossom. Anything can happen.
Absolutely, Buzz and Woody, you said people might get on each other's nerves after 7 years. Can't see parting at each other.
They could, but these guys love each other. I mean, for all they may get on each other's nerves, they're family.
Absolutely, and this is an awesome T-shirt. By the way,
thank you. This is our this is our crew shirt that we just made recently.
Oh wow.
I think the three says it all. I don't think we need to say much more than that.
It certainly does. But what about the pressure? Do you feel any pressure on your shoulders?
There's a huge amount of pressure, but I can't, if I thought about that pressure all the time, I'd never get any work done. There's been pressure every time. There was pressure when we made A Bug's Life. Are we going to be able to follow up our first film?
Yeah.
There's pressure with Toy Story 2. Are we going to be able to make something as good as the first? Mm. Each director in each film has kind of been in the same place. Even Up, our most recent film, for a long time, we all liked the story, and it was very, very funny, and we knew it just had a huge amount of emotion in it. Mm. But it was pretty off the grid. I mean, we've got a main character who's this cranky old man, and he's teamed up with a little Korean scout, having this adventure. That's not high concept. That's an odd, odd idea.
Yeah.
But it's done huge. You know, if we considered what the audience might want or what might make money, we'd be frozen and we would make bad movies.
Absolutely.
We just have to make movies the way we have for the last 15 years, which is to try to tell great stories with great characters and first and foremost make the kind of movies that we'd like to see ourselves, and we've had good luck with that.
Absolutely. I mean, you talked there a little bit about the emotions of the movie. The last three Pixar films for me have progressed in terms of the negative emotion. I mean, Up was incredibly moving. This Toy Story 3, it seems to be moving naturally in that direction. But how do you layer the laughs in there as well? while keeping the poignancy?
Well, you know, I know John Lasseter is fond of quoting Walt Disney, who often said that for every laughter, every bit of laughter, there needs to be a tear.
Yeah.
And I think that's a philosophy that's very much guided us. I mean, when you go to see a movie, you want the full experience. You want adventure, you want action, you want comedy, and you want to feel something. Yeah. You want to feel moved, and maybe you learn something along the way. Toy Story 2 was a very emotional film for a lot of people. There were, you know, specific scenes like, you know, Jesse's song, the Sarah McLachlan song in the middle of the film. People were very moved by that. I think it would be a mistake for us to make a Toy Story 3 and not try to tap into emotion in the same way that we did in 2. And I think we've done it in a really big way.
Oh, fantastic. And can you talk about your visual approach to this movie, not least the 3D part of the equation?
Well, Toy Story 3 is going to be coming out in 3D, as you know. And Up was our first film that came out in 3D. Up wasn't designed to be in 3D, and Toy Story 3 is not designed to be in 3D.
Okay.
We're just trying to make a great movie, and we know that when we create the 3D version, it'll be just that much more visually interesting to watch. We all love 3D. We've been a big fan of it for a long time. But we think it's a mistake to design a movie just for the 3D gimmickry.
Yeah,
you know, we're not going to have Buzz shooting lasers, you know, right into the camera, and you know, we're not going to do stuff just to kind of get our 3D rise out of the audience.
Do the yo-yo.
Yeah, do the yo-yo. You know, ever since the first Toy Story, we've staged our movies in a very different way than animation had typically been staged in hand-drawn animation. You know, we make use of the camera, we move the camera, we stage in depth. We always tried to make our films feel like live-action films in a way, even though they were animated. And that translates great into 3D. I mean, I think strong visual film directors stage in depth regardless of the medium.
Yeah.
And when you stage in depth, when you then convert the movies into 3D, you know, you get a very rich 3D, deep, immersive experience.
Oh, fantastic. John Lasseter just walked past us there.
Did he pass through?
He didn't pass through.
Did he ruin the shot?
He went round the back. I think he's got an innate sense. He doesn't want to ruin the shot. What's it been like working with him in this movie? Obviously, given that, you know, he created the first movie, he was, you know, the second one.
John's great. I mean, John's incredible. He's an incredible visionary. It's been amazing working alongside him for the last 15 years and collaborating with him on a lot of different films. John's been very involved in Toy Story 3. As you know, this is very much his baby. It's really all of our babies, but first and foremost, you know, these are the characters that are nearest and dearest to John. John trusts me very deeply as a collaborator and as a partner, and he knows that these characters are in good hands with me. He checks in and has been involved creatively. He knows what we're up to. He knows about the story that we're telling. He'd love to be directing the movie, frankly, but at this point, he's running two film studios, and there's no directing in his future at the moment.
That takes up his day.
Yes.
From eight to five, he's gone.
Yeah. But again, you know, we've all been used to working very collaboratively with each other over the years, and it's really no different now. I mean, it's not about ideas being mandated. It's about us all talking about what's best for the movie.
Okay, and finally, you've got two more key collaborators in this film, Tom Hanks and Tim Allen.
Yes.
Obviously, you know, Buzz and Woody are iconic characters. You guys know them inside out, but what do they bring to it in terms of recording? Do they bring nuances and maybe lines that you hadn't thought of?
Yeah, well, nobody could play these characters other than them. Tom Hanks is Woody, but Tim Allen is Buzz Lightyear, and, you know, the characters are in their DNA. You know, it was very interesting coming to the first recording sessions for Toy Story 3 because they hadn't been doing these voices in a very long time. But I'll tell you, within 5 minutes, we were off and going, and everything just kind of came right back for them. They've been having a blast playing the characters. They love these characters. They've been pestering us over the years, wondering when we're going to ever make Toy Story 3. So they're all, everyone, Tom, Tim, John Ratzenberger, Stell Harris, Don Rickles, Wally Shawn, everyone's just thrilled to be on board again, and they've been having a blast.
Fantastic.